Again, this is a type of t-test. It uses the t-distribution and the t-table. We won't tell you how to calculate the t-statistic. We'll just assume that you'll use a computer to conduct it. And by now, you should be able to know the interpretation of whatever t-statistic comes out for the output. Then you'll know when to reject or fail to reject the null. The degrees of freedom are important, though. And again, that's just like when we did hypothesis testing with R. The degrees of freedom are n minus 2, where n is the number of data points. So we have n values of x and n values of y. For example, let's say you're measuring the relationship between two variables, x and y, and you have 9 data points. So 9 values of x, the independent variable, and 9 values of y, the dependent variable. And let's say we do a non-directional test at alpha equals 0.05. And then let's say that we calculate our t-statistic and we get 5.77. What can we conclude? There is, or there is not, enough evidence to reject the null. Meaning there does, or there does not, appear to be a significant relationship between x and y.